worship your name, Jesus. We've come into the sanctuary to give you praise, God. Because in the midst of it all, you are our light, and we worship you. We worship you, Jesus. Thank you, God, for who you are. We bless your name, Jesus. There is nobody like you in the earth. No, 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 no. We worship your name, oh God, yeah. The Lord salvation, whom shall I fear? Whom shall I be afraid? The Lord is my light and salvation. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I be afraid? The Lord is my light and salvation. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I be afraid?
Trust in you, Jesus. I will trust.
goodness of the Lord, I will remain. Confident. I'm going to see. Hallelujah. We give you glory and we honor you in this place, God. Hallelujah. We call you holy, God, because you are holy. Hallelujah. We bless your name, God. We've come to give you glory. We've come to give you honor. Yeah, we bless you. We magnify you. We give you glory. We give you honor. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I call you holy, Lord, you are holy, you are so holy to me. I call you holy, Lord, you are holy, holy you are, and holy you'll be, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah.
truthful God. He is the lifter. 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 He is a mighty God.
Great and mighty is our God. You say.
Say, great and mighty is our God.
Great and mighty is our God.
Great and mighty is our God. You say,
great and mighty is our God.
Bless the name of the Most High God. Hallelujah. 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 Bless your name, God. Bless your name, God. We bless your name, God. We bless your name, God. Your name is great. Your name is mighty. You're wonderful. You do all things well.
I feel the spirit in this place. Can we just lift our hands? Because God's worthy to be praised. Let's just lift our hands and give God glory. Because we need him. We need him. Hallelujah. We need you, Lord. We need you, Lord. Right. We need you, Lord. We need you, Lord, right now. And we lift our heads and bow our knees to worship at your throne. We need you, Lord. We need you, Lord, right now. Sing. Whatever situation you're going through, we need you, Lord. We need you, Lord.
We need you, Lord.
We need you, Lord.
We need you, Lord. Right now.
And we lift our
heads. Lift our
heads. And bow on.
And bow on.
To worship.
To worship at your throne.
We need you, Lord.
We need you, Lord.
We need you, Lord.
We need you, Lord. Hey.
We need you, Lord.
King of kings and the Lord of lords is in the atmosphere. Come on. Hallelujah. What an awesome God we serve. This is the day the Lord has made. We have come to rejoice and worship the King of kings and the Lord of lords. There is none like him. Master, King, Savior, Deliverer, Healer, Waymaker, the God that sees us through everything. Father, we thank you this morning for giving us another day in the land of the living. God, we are gracious to be in your presence one more time, that we could lift up our hands and say thank you. We honor you this morning, Jesus, and we welcome you in this place. Hallelujah. For those of you that are in the sanctuary, we welcome you in the matchless name of Jesus Christ. And those of you that are viewing on Facebook, YouTube, and around the world, we welcome you to Calvary Tabernacle service this morning. As we go into the presence of the Lord this morning in prayer, I know there are various needs in the house that everyone has. If you have a need, can you lift your hand up this morning? If you're representing someone that has a need, can you lift your hands up? In fact, let everyone lift their hands up, because we all have needs. Hallelujah. Let's be true to the fact that we all have needs this morning. So we're going to go to our God that will supply all of our needs according to his riches and glory. Father, you know exactly what you need. And in this presence and in this place, God, you are the comforter. You are the healer. You are the way maker. You are the strength that we need this morning. God, lift up the burdens and cover us. Touch us from the crown of our head to the sole of our feet. God, we bring your people before you this morning, that you would strengthen them, even they walk through situations. You would never leave us nor forsake us. God, you would see us through this process. God, we know that all things work together for the good. We don't see it, but we know you would work it together for our good. Oh God, we trust you this morning that you are the author and the finisher of our faith. We understand, God, that even though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, we will fear no evil, God. We understand that this is just a season that you're taking us through, God. And in this too, God, we will find within us to give you praise and glory. Oh, Jesus, we know, God, in this there is a story. And we thank you one more time that the various needs that are in this house and around the world, for those that are watching us, let there be a shift in the atmosphere, God. Undergird your people. Faith cometh by hearing and hearing your word. So, God, establish them in your word this morning. Because without faith, it is impossible to please you. God, this morning, we pray, God, for those that have lost loved ones, those that are in the hospital, those that need a touch of healing this morning. Do a miracle, God Almighty. Reverse that situation. Reverse it, God Almighty. Regulate, God Almighty. Do only what you can do, Jesus. You are the miracle worker, God. By your stripes, we are healed and delivered in the name of Jesus. Oh, God Almighty, we bring our bishop and his family before you this morning. Oh God, and we thank you that we have gotten a time to celebrate, oh God, and lift up your name. We pray, God, as we celebrate our First Lady, we pray, God, as we come into a season of celebration, that you would give us the strength, that you would give us a song, God, in this season. Oh, God, we point our hands to our bishop and the First Family this morning, that you would guide them through this. Oh, God, be there for them, God, as they have been there for us many times. They have sacrificially give their times, their resources to us. So now it's our turn, God, to pour strength into them, to pour help into them, to pour back, God, 100-fold into them, God. Lift them up, God, undergird them, Jesus. Oh, God, weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. Strengthen Lennox and Crystal. Touch them. Touch our bishop, God. Touch the extended family. God, put a fence around them and gather them, God. Let them come together as a family. There is strength in unity. Oh, God, touch them right now. We pray, God Almighty, for our pastor and our lady Janice. We pray, God, for them as they guide us through this process. Oh, God, touch them from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet. Send them help, God Almighty. Send them the resources, God. Lift up his hand, God Almighty, as he guides us through, God. Give him a prophetic word for this season. Oh, God, touch his heart and his mind. Give him a word, God Almighty. Touch him, God, as he channels us through this process. Oh, God, you give him what he needs in the midnight hour, God. Touch them right now. Download upon them, Jesus. Oh, God, we thank you right now. We love you because you first love us. Let your prophetic voice be heard in this service, God. Draw someone to the kingdom for such a time of this. Baptize someone in your precious name, Jesus. Fill them with the Holy Ghost as the Spirit of God give them utterance. Save and deliver, God. Let your anointing flow. Let your glory show up in this house, God. We're under an open heaven, God Almighty. We thank you for the opportunity to lift up your name. Amen. Amen. Thank you. In Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord, Calvary. Praise the Lord again. Today's scripture will be taken from Isaiah 61, verses 1 to 3, and Psalms 24. We'll read alternatively, and I will begin. Isaiah 61, 1 to 3. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because the Lord hath anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek. He hath sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and the opening of the prison to them that are bound. To appoint unto them that mourn in Zion, to give unto them beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, that they might be called trees of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that he might be glorified. In Psalms 24, for he hath founded it upon the seas and established it upon the floods. He that hath clean hands and a pure heart, who hath not lifted up his soul unto vanity, nor sworn deceitfully. This is a generation of them that seek him, that seek thy face, O Jacob. Who is this King of glory? The Lord, strong and mighty. The Lord, mighty in battle. And the last altogether. Who is this King of glory? The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. Praise the Lord. The Lord's word already blessed.
Come on, let's worship him in the house. He is in the room. We're so thankful, God, that you came to abide among us this morning. Hallelujah.
We know that it reaches.
of your hand. Let him pour it to you afresh this morning. Whatever you need, he'll reach to right where you are. Hallelujah.
Coming down from the Father above. Help me sing it.
Sweet home for my spirit forever.
I pray. This morning we need God's peace. Before you take your seats, I just want to ask a favor of you. We have a few more seats left in the ground floor. If you're not immunocompromised, if you wouldn't mind coming down, we need to be together as a family. But before you take your seats, can you just greet one or two people and just give them a hug and say it's going to be okay? It's going to be okay. Forever I pray in fatherless pillows of love. Sweep over my spirit, oh, forever I pray. Sweep over this congregation, Lord, forever I pray. In fathomless pillows of love. Of love. You may be seated if you can in his presence. Sweep on. We thank you this morning, God, for being with us. We sense in this space your presence. And we acknowledge that you're the balm in Gilead, the comforter when we weep. Can we just lift our hands and thank God for being with us this morning? Thank you, Jesus, for being us with us. Well, I'm up here this morning, as you most likely have already heard. On Friday, our First Lady, the matriarch of Calvary, went home to be with the Lord. And today we are suffering an immense loss. She was a powerful, powerful woman of God. And although we're suffering loss this morning, we know that her family is suffering the most loss. So we offer our love and our support to Bishop Lennox Crystal, her entire family, her friends, and you, her Calvary family. In fact, can we stand to our feet this morning and just give a hand clap for the family, the Golson family this morning? Come on, I need to hear a little bit better than that this morning. As you clap, you're saying, we're with you, we love you. And as you deal with such pain, we are here for you. Thank you so much. You may be seated. And I appreciate those that came down from the balcony to be with us on the ground level. Death is painful. They say that death is a price of loving someone. And the pain of grief is what we feel when we lose them. And today we are suffering immense loss. The good news is that God is with us. Can I get an amen? And the other good news is we have each other. And during this next few weeks, next few months, I encourage all of you just to stay together. Be faithful to the house. Come together so that we can mourn, we can heal, we can do this and go through this together. But there's a statement that Bishop often says when people have gone on to be with the Lord. He says that God takes, but he doesn't take all. And this morning, I want to encourage him to say that God took her, and she's now with him, but she's left so much right here in this room. And although we may feel the huge void, she lives on in all of us and leaves a tremendous impact of how she touched the world. She lived a purposeful life, and her impact will live on through the many things that she initiated. Most of us who know her were impacted by her presence. Many of us have a Lady Golson story. She was a pioneer in our church, a leader, an educator. She served in government, and she had the distinction of serving as the first African-American female as a human resources director for Nassau County. She has many accolades, which you'll hear about in the coming days, but much of the systems and the operations of this ministry were all her brainchild. And the vision to encourage and uplift the community through education was also her passion. And so much of what you see in the transformation of a community is partly because of her partnering with our bishop to make it happen. Can we put our hands together for the vision of our First Lady? Throughout this service, you will see her spiritual impact through the lives that she has touched. I could talk for hours about the impact that she had on my life, but because we're asking all of our leaders to keep it to 2 minutes, I will model the behavior. If I was to say one thing about what she did for me in my life, when I was a young, insecure 19-year-old that came from Miami, Florida to come to school in New York, I would say that she became my second mother. When I came up, my parents were afraid to leave me in the devil's den. And there are a few people that they trusted with my care. And I'm so thankful that they trusted my care to Bishop and Lady Golson. Can you put your hands together for the impact that they have made? They took me in as a son. And I tried to become a good son and become part of the family. And so for much of my life here, well, many years in the early days, I lived in their home. I was with them. We traveled together. We bonded as a family. And as my real family likes to say, they're my New York family. And so today, her impact is immense because I feel in part that I've lost a mother. Not in the way that Crystal and Lennox will experience it, but she was so present and so real in my life. And I want to thank her for the contribution she made. I would not be the person I am in this moment without her contribution to my life. And so I give honor this morning to her. At this time, you could put your hands together for that. I'm going to ask Lady Janice to also leave some words in a way that she impacted her as well.
Praise the Lord, everyone. Praise the Lord, everyone. This morning, again, I want to offer condolences to Bishop Lennox and Crystal and all the family and the body of Christ. We feel the pain. It's palpable. There's no denying that we have a great loss. And we're here with you this morning. I want to encourage you that in spite of the hurt and the pain, that we serve a sovereign God. And sovereign means that in spite of our pain and our despair and everything that we're going through right now, He's still God. And I ask each and every one of you this morning to put your confidence and your anchor in the loving arms of God, because He's able to bring you through this. He's able to bring us all through it this morning. So be encouraged in the Lord this morning. I thought about Lady Golson, First Lady Golson, Sister Golson. And as I look back on my life, ever since when we started dating, well, actually courting, we courted Pentecost, she was there. She was there when we got married. She was our MC. She was there through every chapter of our almost 20 years that we're married. Every chapter from beginning until now. Several pages in the chapter. And I'm so going to miss that. Because she's a tremendous blessing in our lives. And can't imagine how we move on, but we will. If I had to say a few words about her, she embodied so much, not so many words, but she was, for those of you who don't know her, she was so classy. She was funny, right? She had a beautiful smile, and out of that smile always radiated her beauty. She was beautiful inside and out. I remember her that when she was going up the ladder, Lady Golson was pulling you up the ladder with her. She was not going to the top and leaving you at the bottom. She was pulling as many as she could go. She was always empowering, encouraging, and she wasn't leaving you. And she was steadfast. I remember her fighting for you. Fighting for you. She served with grace, and I have learned so much from her. And there's not a person here that whose life she has not impacted, and she's not been there. She's been there in some of our, in the best of our lives, some of the most challenging times in our lives, some good days and bad days. She's just always been there, just a strong force, both her and Bishop. And we're tremendously going to miss her. We're going to miss her. But this morning, I encourage you in the Lord. Be strong. And as Pastor Stewart said, this time, the next couple weeks, let us be there for the family. Let us be there for each other. It's going to be a tough time, but I know that with God's grace, that they're going to get through this. We're going to get through this. We love you, and be encouraged in the Lord.
Thank you so much. We're going to show you a quick video we prepared for her when we announced the Joanne Golson Scholarship Program. And as I do that, after that video, you'll hear from a few of our leaders. And again, I'm going to ask them to keep the time. There is no message today, but we felt that our lives would be the message. Amen. So to honor her, I'm going to ask everyone that speaks to please adhere to the 2 minutes, because we want to respect her. We want to respect the family, and we want to respect what we're trying to do in this process. So we want to share this video with you. And the next voices you will hear will be some of our ministers coming to speak about her life.
Because of Lady Gosen, I've learned to use my resources to pursue success in my endeavors.
Because of Sister G, I've learned that tough times doesn't last, tough people do.
Because of Sister G, I'm still in my job and I'm happily married. Thank you, Sister G.
Because of Lady Gosen, I learned what it meant to be a virtuous woman and also the importance of pursuing higher education.
Because of Sister Gosen, we work at summer camp.
Because of Sister Gosen, I was made to feel a part of Calvary's vision.
Now it's up to you. I've heard it said that people come into our lives for a reason, bringing something we must learn, and we are led to those who help us most grow if we let them, and we help them in return. Well, I don't know if I believe that's true, but I know I'm who I am today because I knew you. Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes a sun, like a stream that meets a boulder halfway through the wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? Because I knew. Of me is made of what I learned from you. You'll be with me like a handprint on my heart. And now whatever way our stories end, I know you have rewritten mine by being my friend. Like a ship blown from its by a wind off the sea, like a sea dropped by a sky bird in a distant wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? But because I knew you, because I knew you, I have been changed for good. Just to clear the air, I ask forgiveness for the things I've done you blame me for. But then I guess we know there's blame to share, and none of it seems to matter anymore. Changed for been changed for the better. And because I knew you, because I knew you, because I knew you, I have been changed.
Can we stand and give God a praise for the life of Joanne Hyson Golson? We give you praise, God, for the life of our First Lady. We have been changed because she was here. You may be seated. And from a very young person, she made impact. And I hope her life is an encouragement to every young person in this room. You're never too young to change the world around you. At this time, we're going to ask for our ministers to come in this order. Minister Donna Douglas, Minister Cam Mirage, Minister Everell Garrick, Minister Judith Garrick, Minister Nakisha Laidlaw, and Sister Nisha Walters. And again, I'm asking each of them to take no more than 2 minutes as they encourage us and also they share one part or one thing that Lady Golson left with them. Can you receive them as they come at this time?
Not many people who exemplifies excellence, class, grace, power, and kindness like First Lady Joanne Golson. I met her for the first time in 1975. And in my walk with God, she's always been there. I remember that year, she was on the missions committee. And the theme of that conference was a going church for a coming Christ. And she was just also involved in every facet of the church. There's some things that I've taken from her life because I saw that the good that came from her. I think the only department Lady Golson didn't have working was the men's group. And she was probably behind it in some way. And I'm sure Bishop can testify to that. But she exemplifies so much grace and poise. No matter what the situation is, she just has a way of bringing peace into it. Bishop Lennox Crystal, your mom stood as a tower. She left a legacy behind that will go on for generations. And for me, the thing that I will hold on to dearest was that she taught me that God's people are precious. She said, Donald, it doesn't matter what they do, where they go, when they come, love them. They are God's people. And I will hold on to that, and I'll forever hear her. So hold on. Hold on. She will be your strength with God through these times. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. My condolences to Bishop Crystal Lennox and the entire Calvary family. There's so much to say about this great woman. I met her when I was 12 years old. And I can also say she was a second mother. She helped me to become the woman I am today. She was able to help those who think they were too high and those who think they were too low. I was sitting with Lennox yesterday and I shared a story with him. There was one time she had Christmas parties for the community in the youth center. And those parties, they always fall on my birthday. And I would always help try to help her to plan those parties, and they're not little parties, and over 150 kids would come in, not only Calvary kids. She would just fill the youth center with kids and had all these activities. So she heard someone talking to me saying that it was my birthday. Then she came to me and she said, "Are you having a party?" So I said, "Yes, this is the party." Then she said, Then she said, "Is there an after party?" So I said, "Yes, we're cleaning up." So then I stayed with her. We cleaned up and we were always late. It's always late cleaning. And then next day, it was a Saturday. The next day was Sunday. The church was early. And during the church service, she came to me and she said, "Sister Kayon, here's your birthday gift." That touched me so much. It wasn't expected. If you thought you were too low, she was able to pull you up. If she thought you were too high, she was able to help you as well. There was one scripture, this became my favorite scripture. She said, "Whenever I'm doing anything, think on these things. Finally, brethren," I'm sorry, "whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think on these things." She taught me this. This scripture became my favorite scripture because she said, "Just think on these things." Bishop Crystal Lennox, we love you. We're here for you. We will support you. We're here for you. God bless you.
Praise the Lord, Calvary. Oh, Sister Golson, there's so much I could say about Sister Golson. When I first came to Calvary, she was my teacher in the class. And that lady taught me so much. I always loved her posture. I never heard that lady shout a day in my life. She was just a classic lady. A classic, classic lady. And there's so much I could say. But to Bishop Lennox and Golson, just want to tell you that, you know, we are praying for you. Me and my family, we're praying for you. And whatever it is, Bishop, we're there for you. Whatever it is, Lennox and Golson, we are there for you. We just want to say thank you. Thank you for everything that you have done. And, you know, it's just, I just don't know what to say. After Friday, I heard. Friday, I was at home when Judy called me and told me, and from Friday, I've been down. And, you know, knowing, you know, the kind of person she was, and see all of this. But Bishop, we love you, and just be strong, or we'll be there for you. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everyone. My story would be longer than 2 minutes, but I just want to say, I love this church. I love coming to this church. I love the fact that I can serve God through the ministry of this church. And it's all because of how Lady Gosa made me feel when I first came here.
Praise the Lord, Calvary. Bishop,
Lennox, Crystal. We're thinking of you this morning. When I think of Lady Golson, I talk from a place of a new member coming to Calvary, two young kids. And under her teaching, her imprint that she left on me, I mentioned to Minister Donna yesterday, we're called to influence. And Lady Golson did that every time she stepped in our presence. She influenced us in some way, shape, or form. She left her imprint on us. She personified grace and elegance. She made us feel as a woman how we should carry ourselves. She was a living example of what we should be. Lady Golson set the bar high. She set the status quo. If we could only live to be compared to who and what she was an amazing woman. And she spoke life into my life. She sent prayers as a woman who, my husband wasn't in the church, and she prayed for me. I know of who she is and what she stood for. I know a love that she gave. When I hear she worked in HR, that's who she was. We call it D&I, diversity inclusion. She made everyone feel like somebody here. Everyone. We love her, and we are carrying you. We're lifting you up today.
Bless the Lord, everyone. Condolence to the Golson family. When I first met Lady Golson, we were at a group, speech choir group. She take us to this big house, and she make sure everything was okay. And every second she asked, all right, you have food? You have clothes? You need this? You need that? She was just like a mother in her own way. As we turn, we buck up into her because she's just wanted everything to be good with us. We had such a wonderful time because of her. I love her grace, her smile. Even when I visit her in the hospital, oh my God, I think that she had on some makeup. She looks so smooth. She looks so, I don't know. She just looks so lovely. Oh my God. I'm telling you, I never see that lady. I didn't see like she quarrel, she fussy or anything. She just have this warm countenance. Oh my God, I just want to be around her every time. And I just want to encourage your family. Lean on me when you're not strong. And I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on. No, it won't be long when I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. You can call on me, Bishop. I'll be there. You can just call on me, Bishop Lennox Crystal, and I will be there. You can just call me. I'll come running. I just want to encourage you that you can call on me. I'll be there. If you need me, Bishop, if you need me, Lennox Crystal, I'll be there. In Jesus' name.
Lean on me, somebody to lean on. You just might have a problem. Come on, him is it. Say, lean on somebody
to lean on.
Well, it is true. Can you stand to your feet? We're going to thank you for those words. She was also a person that could never be pinned down to a style or preference. She was broad. She knew a lot of people. She connected with a lot of people, but she also loved music. And so throughout the course of this Sunday, we're going to be giving you different stylistic flavors that we feel capture her. And we're going to start with going back a little bit to the oldies. I may say the oldies. So this morning, as we do this section, I want you to join us in worship. We're going to have Elder Debbie come and lead us, but she's not going to be singing alone. We want to hear your voice. How many know that the old account was settled long ago? Come on, look at somebody, say, the old account was settled long ago. Because he's a strong arm to lean on this morning. Come on, put your hands together and thank God because we have a strength and he's a strong arm to lean on. Thank you, Elder Debbie. You may be seated. You may be seated. We are again so thankful and so appreciative that God is with us. And so we're going to be hearing from a first set of elders, and then we'll also hear from the second set as well. that are coming at this time in order. Again, we're going to ask them just to stick to the two-minute time frame we've given them. So we're going to start with Elder Wayne, Elder Dawn, Williams, Elder Janetta, Elder Vish, Elder Sermo, and Dr. K. So again, Elder Wayne, Elder Dawn, Williams, Elder Janetta, Elder Vish, Elder Sermo, and Dr. K. Can you receive our elders as they come with their reflections this morning?
Praise the Lord, everybody. God is good all the time. God is good. Lady Joanne Goldson, she was my sister, my friend, my confidant. I've known her just about all my life. My sister and her went to the same high school. I was reflecting on our childhood growing up. I remember those days walking her to Sarah Street to a place we call Kingston Gardens. She was the epitome of style and grace. Two things I could say about her that is undisputed. She was one of the most brilliant persons I know. Brilliant mind. I actually was visiting a physician yesterday and I told him I'm Joanne Pass. And he said to me, Wayne, in my practice, she is one of the few persons that taught me things that I never knew in medical science. He said to me, she had a brilliant mind. Not only did she have a brilliant mind, but she had no bitterness in her. She had no guile. She will be upset with you and tell you the truth, but she'll do it in love, and she'll move on. She had an unstained innocence, and she was just a sweet person inside and out. I remember, ministry-wise, a lot of the ministries that started here at Calvary, we did it together. Counseling ministry. I remember teaching the young kids she and I started, and that Academy Charter School you see. She was the pioneer that we worked together to start that with teaching some of the kids here at Calvary, and it grew from here to the Academy. I thank God for her life. I've known she touched the lives of many people. She was very personal to me. And it's hard for me to stay into the 2 minutes, but I'll be good. I just want to say I praise God for her. And the scripture says, unless a grain of seed falls into the ground and dies, it abideth alone. But this grain of seed have brought forth much fruit. Much fruit. And the scripture says, precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his saints. This is a precious moment. God bless you.
Praise the Lord, everybody. This morning, I'm speaking on behalf of John, my husband. Bishop Lennox, Crystal, your prayers are with you. I know Joanne to be a very happy person, always smiling. She always said to me, Dawn, you know, you can say the meanest thing in the nicest way. Always remember your tone.
Right.
And I remember one time she come over to me and she say, John not giving it to you? You know that we ladies can get anything from our husband. And we always talk a lot about, you know, getting under our husband's skin to do what they said no. But this morning I want to remember Lady G, as we affectionately call her, in a very happy way. Praise God.
I've known Lady Golson since 1996, the first day when I walked into this church. She has been my mentor. She has been my teacher. She has been my friend. She has instilled so much into me. I remember when I first became the apostolic leader, Bishop and Lady Golson was talking to me. I remember Lady Golson was telling me that, Janetta, you can do this. I'm like, I can't do this. I don't even have a clue. But you know what? With her grace and with her strength, she guided me and she ensured that I do the things that she's instilling in me. I'm so happy that I've come to know her. My heart is broken in many pieces. I cannot explain. And as my daughter said to me this morning, Mommy, you're not showing any emotions. I said, Sophia, I do show emotions when the time is right, when I'm by myself. You know, but Lady Golson will live on in my life, in the things that I do. Bishop Crystal Lennox, you are my family, and I will always be there for you. Amen.
Thank you. Lady Golson, like so many have, is a pioneer in so much what we see today. And I am a result of so many things that she have done in this ministry. And personally, when I came to Calvary, Bishop and Lady Golson took me on as their son. Many times, after church, in the beginning stage, I would be there on Sunday evenings, eating with Lady G and Bishop, and we'll have a great time. The Golson's family have become a family to me in so many ways. And I believe, personally, that has molded me, just watching them live life and being themselves. And Bishop, your example to in the late nights when a lot of people do, we used to have Wednesday night, and I would come over to the house, and you'd say, Vish, come and eat, because I was single. Come and eat before you go home. And Lady G would go home, she would cook something quick. You would just come from preaching. And I would just see Bishop jumping in and being a husband, and you see the other side of him being a real person behind the preacher. And that taught me so much. You ministered to me so much of being a husband when I became one. And that taught me how you treat your wife and what you said to her in those moments. So that was just a blessing in by itself. And I will share this. It may sound funny to you. As I started to come to church, I was born in Trinidad, but now people say I'm Jamaican. All right? So they make fun of me at work and said, I don't hear you talk about Trinidad. You talk about Jamaica like you were born there. So I said, you know what? That's true. I was born again. All right. So I stayed a few nights at Bishop's house. This was a long time ago. And Crystal could attest to this. I woke up. Lady G said, Vish, Brother Vish, breakfast is ready. Come down and eat. So I can't said, yes, Lady G. Wow, that scrambled egg looks good. She said, Vish, you don't know a thing. That is Aki. Crystal. Well, you know Crystal. If you know Crystal, she wouldn't let that go. And, you know, she was just having fun with me. She said, Brother Vish, you don't know what is Aki? I said, I don't know. I said, I know what roti is. All right. So with that said, I enjoyed my time with her. And she was a blessing. And I would never forget that. And she baked the cake for our wedding. And she gave a lot. It was tremendous. My goodness. Blessing. And also, she established spiritual blessing when she taught the Abundant Life class. She was firm and sweet, but make sure that the word is important. She taught that you have to create systems in your life. And we can see today what she did. And there was one lesson, Bible lesson, that she did that stuck with me and helped me manage a lot of what I do. She said, you have to be a good steward of what God puts in your hand. Don't let the blessing come in your hand and mismanage it. She said, establish the word of God and manage everything that God puts in your hand. Don't waste it. She said, if you waste it, it's not good management. And that stuck with me, how I manage my life. And I thank you, the Goldson family, for allowing us to share her with us in so many ways. Your sacrifice, your love, right? Many times she should have been home, but you saw the kingdom's agenda and it all benefited all of us. Thank you.
Praise the Lord, Calvary. To Bishop Crystal Lennox and entire family, our condolences, our love goes out from myself, Felicia, Alex, our entire family. Sister G, Lady Golson, Mother Golson, Elder Joanne, right? Because remember, she is an elder in the Lord's church too, amen. She was such, I would say the word, is fittingly so, is influence, really, that described her, influence. In the entertainment world, folks that are in entertainment, they always revere people who they say are a triple threat, right? Folks that can act, sing, dance, right? Those are the folks that, like, wow, full entertainers. So when I thought about that, I thought about Lady Golson because she was even more than a triple threat, amen, in the different areas that she could influence you, right? So there's spiritual, there's family. You know, she was there for us, praying for us before we had Alex, and she was there, came to the hospital when we were there as well. She was working with, Felicia worked with her on many of the different projects here and the core values, worked with her, and she was somebody that challenged you to operate in excellence. Also, she taught the 8-week course when we're doing the career advancement for the 8-week course, and so she taught me how to negotiate salary raises, taught me how to negotiate different jobs, going from one job to another. So she could advise you and influence so many different areas in so many different ways. So it was such a blessing to be able to be here, to be associated, to experience her for the time that we did. So I am grateful. My family is grateful. We're better off because we knew her. We're better off because of her influence. And we thank you for allowing us to be a part of the Calvary family and Bishop, your extended family. We thank you. We thank Lady Golson. God bless.
Praise the Lord, everyone. Praise the Lord. Lady Golson, Lady G. I give God thanks and praise for Sister Golson. As I came to Calvary in 2008, Sister Golson received me with her arms wide open. And when she, as she got to know me, she gave me a scripture for my life. And that scripture is Job chapter 38, verses 31. I had the opportunity to shadow Sister Golson, as the Lord had placed in my spirit, which I did. And one day she asked me, she said, Dr. K, why are you treating me so nice? I said, Lady Golson, it's what the Lord wants me to do. And she welcomed that. I traveled with Sister Golson, Crystal and Lennox and Bishop. Thank you for the opportunity to travel with Lady Golson. Lady Golson took me to Jamaica by her mother's home. I went there for 1 week, and I ended up spending 2 weeks in Jamaica with Lady Golson. So much to say about this woman of God. She has impacted my life. Sister Golson would correct you, and you don't even realize that she corrected you. She had such grace. She had such love. Her personality, oh my God. They once said, if you hear a story of somebody, you could take a page out of their life. But Calvary, we could take so many pages out of the book of the life of Lady Goldson. She has impacted our lives so much. I had the opportunity to go and visit her before the holidays. And as I went to visit her, Lennox turned to her and Lennox said, "Mommy, Dr. K is here." And she said, "Yes, yes, 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 yes." And she just laughed. That memory, forever. Forever I've stamped in my spirit. Went to the hospital and visited Sister Goldson. What I saw was the glory of Almighty God upon this woman of God. Bishop Lennox and Crystal, Sister Gail, know that you know that you know. There is a peace within our souls, knowing that it is well with Lady Goldson. It is well with the Spirit of God. As the Shunammite woman said, it is well. She have lived a life. She have set an example. The influence that she have left behind. Oh God, may we mimic it. May we embrace it. May we live as Lady Goldson lived. May our personalities emulate this woman of God. Help us, Jesus. You have given us a living stone, an open book, seen and read by all men. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. Great things he have done. Bishop Lennox, Crystal, Sister Gail, God have you in the very palm of his hands. Nothing happens unless the Lord allows it. And Bishop, your word that you always preach to us, all things are working together for your good, the Goldson's family good, and the children of God in Calvary, for the entire family. All of it is working for our good in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Come on, give a praise for the elders. Amen. Test. Hallelujah. Before we go into another song selection, we just also want to say that as Dr. K said, the Bible says we are living epistles, seen and read of men. And I think she's a great example in our lives. I hope your life is an epistle that God will be pleased with. Amen. But what we're doing, somebody like this, you need a whole month to celebrate them. Can I get an amen? You can't do it in a homegoing service. So we realize that her funeral services, which we'll share with you shortly, will be an international event. There will be people coming from around the world to celebrate with us. So we wanted to give our folks here a chance to express yourselves. So we're doing two things. One is, if you remember at the 30th, we announced that we're going to be doing a book that will be on everything that Lady Goldson taught us. And so if you'd like to be a part of that book, where's Felicia? Felicia, can you stand, please? Felicia, if you could please see Sister Felicia Barracks. We're going to be creating that book for the family, for our church, so we can have a record of how she impacted our lives. Amen? Put your hands together for that. Amen. Also, if you'd like to leave a greeting or tribute or remark, next week and for the next couple of weeks, we'll be showing videos that will feature many of you that want to leave your thoughts, leave your expressions. So if you'd like to do that, please see Elder Houghton, and you know who he is. He's over here. Please see him, and you can set up a time to come in and record your greetings so that we can also see what she did in your life. In fact, if she personally touched you in any way, if you're here tonight, can you stand if she personally touched you, if you're impacted by her in any way, all this room, put your hands, look at this, keep the energy up for me, Elder. Amen. Come on, put your hands together if she impacted you in any way. Amen. And so We want to give you an opportunity to do that. And we also want to say that if you were new to Calvary, because she's been dealing with sickness for a while, so even my son said, you know, Daddy, I mean, I know her, but I can't even remember much about her. And said, son, it's doubtful that you would have been here if it wasn't for Lady Golson. So even for generations, she still leaves an impact. Amen. And if you're sitting here, you may not have got to know her personally. I guarantee you what you see, what you experience, and this whole ministry is all her stamp of excellence that she's left upon the lives of all of us. And you may not notice because we don't really put it out there, but she was born in Kingston, Jamaica. Well, Kingston, Jamaica, was it? Okay, I don't make sure. I don't have the... and we're not a church that is overly cultural or sticks to our culture. We are diverse and we're broad, and that's by design. But this morning, we thought that we should take a little bit of time to go back to the yard. So can you stand to your feet? I say it because they make fun of the way I say it. Did I say it right? No. Amen. Can we praise God together as we celebrate and go back to the Caribbean?
Oh,
is over, we shall wear a crown. Come on, somebody give God a praise. We have a hope. Come on, shout and say, we have a hope. And one day we'll see Jesus face to face. Woo! Hey, you may be seated. Write my name up there. And one of these old days. Thank you, praise team. We're going to be hearing from the second group of elders that are coming to share the reflections, and these will be the last reflections for this day. We're going to be hearing from Elder Joan Seeley, Elder Dawn West, Elder Debbie White, Elder Philip Walters, and Sister Claudette Harrison, in that order. And again, how many are thankful that they're keeping to their time? Can you put your hands together? Thank you so much for honoring us so that we can hear from everyone this morning.
Praise the Lord, Calvary. Praise the Lord, Calvary. I stand here, I don't even know what to say. I'm telling you this, I've been reflecting and reflecting and reflecting. And this is what I'm going to just say to you. I bought a house at 413 Spruce Place in 1993. No, hear the story. Don't laugh. There's an impact to this. In 1993, my neighbors were Pastor Goldson, Lady Goldsner, I used to call her Sister Goldson, Lennox, and I remember Crystal was about two years old. Lennox was about 8, 10 going to school. I was the partying neighbor. Yes. I did not know Christ. I know God. Yes, that's why when I dance there, I don't care what you say. I'm dancing for the soul that they influence me to give to God. You understand? It's not easy because when I sit and I reflect on it, I reflect on the impact they have on my life. I may not come around here and boast about it or whatever, but they impacted my life in so many ways. Yes, and I do love them deeply. I may not run around. I'm not that type of person. But my heart knows where it is. My soul was delivered to the Lord through this family. I could not see it. And you know what? When I got saved and I walk away, Lady Golson said, she's coming, Sister Joan. She said, Sister Joan, you're not coming back. I said to her, I can't handle that. I said it. I sat in her car in the front seat. She took me up one day. We went for a drive. I sat in the car in the front seat. She said, Sister Joan, come back to church. I said, I can't handle it. I don't like it. She said, Sister Joan, you're going to come back. It was a year more or so when I walked through that door. 10 o'clock in the morning, I was doing gardening. And the impulse was so strong on me to get up and go to church. As I was coming in that door, she was in the trunk of the car, opening the trunk of the car, and she laughed. She said, Sister Joan, I told you. She said, Sister Joan, I told you. I'm saying she was a mother. I was impressed about the gentleness, the gentle aura that surrounds First Lady. The peaceful aura, the speech, the gentle speech, it impacts your life. It makes you think, how can I be like that? How am I not like that? But then when you read the scriptures, the Lord always gives us an example. She was the human example of the Proverbs 31 woman. And she's a reflection and an education for all of us. All of you, my sisters, here, reflect on Lady Goldson. Reflect on what she did, how she did it, how she speak. It's going to be a process. It's going to be a process. But she was the example for us that the Lord placed before us. Bishop, I love you guys with all my heart. I want to say to you, the Lord said to Paul when he gave him that plague-like symptoms, he said, my grace is sufficient for you. And even though you guys are walking through the valley of the shadow of death, I know God's grace is sufficient. And he said, in your weakness, his strength is made perfect. And so today my prayer, and they will all give that prayer, because it's something you have to walk through, you can't run in it, that God's grace, his peace, you understand, and his understanding, his love just envelops you. Let the spirit just overflow you guys in your moment of weakness. I continue to pray for you. I love you guys very much. God bless you.
Praise the Lord, everyone. To Bishop, to Lennox, and to Crystal, on behalf of my family, we extend our deepest condolences to you. I am on my knees praying for your strength. May God continue to keep you, and I can truly say, death, where is your sting? You're in his hands. When I reflect back on Lady Elder Joanne Golson, my heart goes back to 17 years ago, to a faithful and obedient woman. I had heard of Calvary Tabernacle some 17 years ago, and I actually went out in pursuit. I was riding around the neighborhood looking for this church. And I give God glory for Lady Golson, because by the unction of the Holy Ghost, she got up one Saturday and walked into a nail salon where I frequented and got my nails done. And I was sitting there, full of the world, full of life. I was Dawn West at that time. And she was in there and she was talking, such a beautiful spoken woman. Such elegance, such grace. And she was talking with the shop owner. And the shop owner said, what's the name of your church again? And she said, it's Calvary Tabernacle. And I could have fell out of my seat, because I said, Lord, I've been riding around the village of Hempstead looking for Calvary Tabernacle. And I said, if you're talking to me in this moment, knowing that I need a church home and knowing that I need you in my life right now, this woman has a coat on to walk out the door, but she'll get up and she'll come back here where I'm at. I couldn't have said it fast enough. She got out of her seat. She walked, and not only did she walk back to where I was, she stood directly in front of me. And the Lord said, now or never. And I got up and I walked to her. I said, what's the name of your church again? And she said, Calvary Tabernacle. With such an anointing, she left an impact. She says, come this Sunday, come tomorrow. She gave me 3 business cards, and me being Dawn West, didn't comply. But her anointing was so strong that whole entire week, it pulled and it pulled and it pulled on my spirit. And I got up that following Sunday, I entered the doors. Joanne pulled me from the platform, from the pews, placed me into the new convert class, and I became a convert. Led by the Spirit, nurtured me, poured into me, not just me, but my entire family, impacted my children. Every intricate part of my life, I can open up to that woman and share, and she nurtured me as a spiritual mother. Not only did she follow the unction to go to that nail salon one day, she followed the unction of the Holy Ghost to step down from her role as the evangelism leader. And she opened the door with grace and allowed me to step in. And here I am today, 17 years later. I'm no longer Dawn West. I'm Elder Dawn West, standing on the platform of God. spiritual mother is what I call her. My spiritual life was birthed through her love and her nurturing. My children are indebted to her. I remember my son was in school and I needed after school care. And she got him enrolled into our Calvary program and she mentored him. He had difficulty writing, and the teachers would say, well, we don't know if we write in Spanish script or what. And she said, Sister Dawn, I'm going to show him how to write. You turn the pages sideways, and you let him write space by space. My son has great penmanship because of her nurturing and her tutoring and her love for children and education. I'm so blessed by this spiritual family. I'm not who I am without you. And my heart is totally indebted to you. I give God praise for the woman and the tutelage and the gift that he has given us through Lady Joanne Golson. And I will continue to lift you all in prayer. We're walking step by step with you, Bishop, day by day, until we all do what she has done and get to see her again in glory. God bless you all.
Praise the Lord, church. When I was a kid, about 1972, thereabout, I met Sister Joanne Gale, and this was through the influence of Bible quiz. I wasn't a quizzer then, but I was a help. I was a quizzer helper. And her family was known throughout Jamaica for cake baking. If you had a wedding and they weren't the ones baking your cake, well, there's so much to say. They were good. Excellent, I must say. And I never realized that Sister Joanne then, she was cousins to the family of my first pastor, the Palmers. Forwarding to 2003, the word-based Calvary that I came to know influenced the life of my family, and so Calvary became my home church. And when you talk about a word-based church, I'm talking about having a pastor then, Pastor Barrington Golson, and Lady Golson, as I've always called her. They are strong in the word, and this is a word-based church. And that's the reason I'm here. Calvary influenced my life and the life of my family. Now, working on the tutelage of Lady Golson, I had her authority at a point in my life to oversee Calvary's community Christmas party. And what she allowed me to do was to sign for her, which means I would sign my name, Deborah White, on the letterhead of Calvary for Joanne Golson. And in preparing for this Christmas party, I'm talking about the participation of the entire Hempstead community, where I experienced over 350 kids coming to a Christmas party back in that time when I had that responsibility. I had corporations like that of McDonald's, just to name a few, and I'll not name any more, but quite a few corporations were very involved, where I was able to have a zero budget party an announcement never had to be made to the congregation for you to contribute gifts or money. No money at all from the church funds, nobody's pocket. It was all involvement from corporation. And that was all because of Sister Golson, Lady Golson's influence. I admire her poise, her charm, her grace. I've always had very high regards and admiration for the conduct of her behavior. And thus, ever since I've always known her as a pastor's wife, even before her husband became a bishop, I've always called her Lady Golson. I don't know why, but I've always done that. And I've seen later in the years, so many people, I've always been calling her Lady Golson. Why? She has always been covering leading lady. And I thank God for her life. Her influence is seconded to none. And I'm really happy that I have had a chance to be a part of her life. Now, you wouldn't know, but Crystal knows. I've not been very well since the month of January. So I've always wanted to visit her, and I've had to be changing my dates. And today was my date to go fellowship with her. So just imagine me being at work, and I never had reason to be by my phone because my phone is never ever near me, working with kids who are offered a certain condition. And I just looked on my phone and I said, why is the Pastor Stewart calling me at this time of the morning? When I opened, I saw elders. I said, this must be important. The very blood and energy drained from my body. And I was asked by my nearest co-worker, what's the problem? I showed her the note to read. I cannot explain to you where I've been. And I just said, geez, G-E-E-Z, oh God. That was my expression. And I said, Lord, you have done something that is of your order. We can't go against your will. And I just want to be thankful for what you have done. Bishop, Crystal, Lennox, my emotions are not always worn on my sleeves or on my face. But I just want you to know, you're in a prize. Condolences from my family. I love you, we love you. It's not just something I just want to say or I have to say. But I really want you to know that we love you. Crystal, I really, really love you. Not that I don't love your brother, but Crystal, I do. I do love you. Brethren, we stand in the word of God. We stand in his promise. And as I stood here and I sang that hymn that she loved so dearly long ago, her account has been settled. It was settled long ago. You're invited today to pay up. Come, get your account settled. Come on, settle, 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 settle. It will be okay. God is with us, and we want to thank him. We honor you, Lady Golson. Bless the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everyone. I didn't get an opportunity to meet First Lady Golson, to have a conversation with her. But just hearing the stories about this great woman of God impacts me greatly. And even when I pull on the cards that, you know, some of the initiative that she worked on in the past, I could just hear her voice just speaking to me through these cards and different things that she had developed. and it speaks how much she's passionate about what she's doing. Also, when we went to visit her, two young persons were there, and how they spoke highly of her just tells me how much she had impacted the lives of the young people. And last night I get to learn that not only that she had one God child, but she had multiple God children. And it really speaks volume of how this woman has had impact many, many lives. This morning while I reflect on her, while I was praying for the family and I reflect on her, the word that came to me is that she was indeed a legendary woman of God. And not only did she impact the lives here at Calvary, but it extended into the community through her passion for the children and passion for education. We have the Academy Charter School that has blessed this community in such an awesome and tremendous way. And Bishop Crystal and Lennox, you have comforted many of us through a time of bereavement and sadness of losing someone in our lives. And we just want to extend to you that when we reciprocate the same love that you have shown to us and let you know that we love you and we are here to support you and to encourage you as you go through this time. God bless you. God keep you. God comfort you. And let his peace be with you in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. My story goes back over 20-something years. I'm not even sure how many years. But Lady G and I had a good relationship. My brother used to come up from Jamaica. I used to drop him here and go to my church. But then on Sunday nights, Bishop always had Sunday night service. So when I brought my brother back, I would come. Sometimes I'll stay. Sometimes I'll go back home. But then I started staying because I kind of enjoyed the service and the word. So on Monday morning at 10:30, I would come and Sister Nation would always have a cassette for me because I needed to listen to the word. But the way Lady G impacted me, she was such a wonderful person. At church, not at church. And my late husband used to go to the Baptist church. And I'm like, okay, that's where you want to go? Fine. I'm going where I'm going. But then I spoke to Sister Golson, and she encouraged me about sometimes maybe you need to go with him, and then he'll come with you and all of that. And I says, I don't think so. He's too stubborn when it comes to that. So eventually, Bishop, Crystal, and Lady G would come to my home. And they talked to him, and when they came, I went upstairs. I'm like, they're not here for me, they're here for him. But the way Sister Golson really impacted my life was, you know, most of the time you're in a church, and it's all about church, and that's all they want to talk about. Sister Golson would encourage me, like, you have a relationship with your husband. This is what you have to do. You have to sometimes give in, let them think it's all their thoughts. But, you know, you have to work. And I said, oh, okay. So eventually he got hurt on his job and they took him off his job and I had to be like the main breadwinner and he was not enjoying that. She says, Claudette, you have to work with him. Let him feel useful. Let him be the man that he's supposed to be. And I'm so glad and grateful that all that she poured into me, I paid attention to, because when he passed 21 years ago, I was like devastated. And I remember calling Bishop and Lady G answered the phone. And I said to her, Junior passed. She says, what? I said, Junior passed. She said, we'll be there. And they did come and they supported me. And I'm so grateful for the relationship I've had with the Golsa family. It's phenomenal. I can't begin. I could stay here for the next half an hour and tell you stories, but God's been good, and I'm grateful for the relationship I had with her.
Thank you, Trustee Harrison. Amen. Have you enjoyed this morning? Amen. It's funny because so much things have lined up in this transition, but our theme this year is empowered to influence. And if there's one person on this planet that was empowered to influence, it would have been Lady Joanne Golson. And I pray that you came to this service and the living epistle that she was, you've read, and hopefully you can apply some of these principles to your life and examples to your life. Because I think what's happening in our season, some have become so closed in, and they don't realize that their whole life, their whole existence is to give out and be a blessing. Amen. Amen. So at this time, before we receive our offering, and we're going to sing a couple more songs, and you're going to hear from Bishop, and we'll close. We just want to also thank family that loves in all seasons and all times. I just want to thank, and Bishop will say more, but thanks Wayne, excuse me, Mr. Wayne Houghton, thank you so much for being with us this morning. Thank you, Robert, for coming. Come on, put your hands together for his family. Thank you, Aisha, Ashanti, and Brigadier General. Yes, Brigadier General Andrew Gail Bennett. Can you put your hands together for his family that dropped everything and came right away? And he'll say more when he comes up. Amen. But as I grow old, I realize that all the stuff we call and we focus on is fluff. But family is forever. And I'm thankful that you're part of our family. Amen. Well, it's time to give. And the ushers are preparing you this morning. And as they do, I just want to share three primary objectives that I have in my heart as we go through this season for the family. First, I'm going to ask you to help me and assist me in the next couple months. Can we make our priority Bishop, Lennox, and Crystal? Let me say that one more time. I said, can we make our priority Bishop, Lennox, and Crystal? Amen. I'm going to ask everybody to be discerning. Engage your spiritual awareness and understand what they need and even read into it before they can say it. Can I get an amen? Can I get some agreement in the house? Amen. So I was saying to Crystal, Crystal was saying, you know, everybody's asking me what I need. So she said, well, I'd like to have some Broadway tickets. So I'm going to make sure you have Broadway tickets, Crystal. We've tried to stage this so it's not overwhelming. So in the first day or so it was his family. Yesterday it was leadership. And starting today, some of the youth church members that have been with them, known them, we're going to give you an opportunity to go by and visit with them. And obviously we can have 300 people showing up at the house. Amen. So I'm going to ask Elder Joan, can you stand please? Okay. If you'd like to go by the house, we're going to send out a text right after the service, give you... Please reach out to Dr. Seeley, and she will schedule times for you to go by that are convenient for them so we can just show them some love and be there for them. And I'd ask you, when you go by, don't say much. Just be there. Can I say amen? Just say I love you and let them know that you're there for them. The second thing we want to ensure that's done in this season is ensure that as a family, we're dealing effectively with this grief and this loss. And so on Tuesday night, we're going to be holding a prayer service here in the sanctuary. We're going to invite everybody to come. We're just going to pray together and just ask God to be with us as we go through this process. And we've asked all the focus group leaders, they'll be holding town hall meetings or group meetings on Zoom just to make sure we kind of get a gauge of where everybody's at. Because how many know in a season of loss, we all feel the pain? Amen. So we've been working through that grief together as a corporate body. And then lastly, my biggest assignment is to ensure that Lady Golson has the greatest homegoing service we get to give her. Can I get a witness and amen? when she passed, I'm not sure if I should be even saying this, but Bishop said to me, he said, well, Robert, Joan decided that she wanted to be your first funeral for a member. And I thought it was such a horrible thing for him to do to me. But I owe that, and you better believe I'm going to, with every ounce of my being. Ensure that it's done with excellence. Ensure that it's timely, because Crystal told me she doesn't want to go on forever. But we will do it in a way that would honor her and honor her legacy. Do I have some help in here to make that happen? So the funeral arrangements for Lady Golson will be Friday, February 10th, 2023. The lying in state will be from 5 to 7 on Friday. The celebration of life service will be at 7 p.m. And then on Saturday, February 11th, there'll be a laying in state from 9 to 10, and the homegoing service will be at 10 a.m. And we're looking forward to celebrating her life and showing her to the world as who she was. I want to just honor and thank all of you that are watching online. Many people are texting me that they're so humbled to be a part of this, even if they can't be here in person. Can you put your hands together for all those that are watching around the world today? I also wanted to, as they prepare you, everybody prepared, I just want to acknowledge those that came right into town, young people that love her. I know Alexia. Did anybody just come right into town when they heard the news? Amen. Could you put your hands together for those that just dropped everything and came to be with us? We truly appreciate it. Amen. Well, we're about to give, and we here at Calvary know that giving is a tremendous opportunity that God has given us. Amen. And one of the things that she taught us, and Janice says it often, but I'll say it for Janice. I don't know if most of you remember, but when she was around and she would do this, she would say that if you really want to exercise the blessings of the Lord, you need to tithe and give what you want God to give you. I'm going to remember that. Can you wave your hand if you remember? That's her thing. If you want an increase on your job, tithe what you believe that God will perform in your life. Do you have any witnesses in the house that tried that and that you have proven that worked? Can you stand? I need to see where you're at. Tithe what you're believing for God to fulfill and do in your life in advance, and He will bless you. Amen. Thank you so much. All those that are tithing this morning and giving, can you remain standing? We just want to honor you and thank you for your faithfulness to the house of the Lord. We found out that when we give to the Lord, He gives to us. And if you don't have an envelope or you have not gone to the line on this side, you can give by ATM. We can give by Zelle. We're phasing out Faith Life. So if you are giving by Faith Life, we're trying to have you move over to Zelle. So if you could do that in the season. Also, when you leave here today, your statements will be ready for you. Some of them will be ready for you. So you check with the ushers as you go, because your yearly statements are ready. If you don't see your statements, they'll be mailed to you. Amen. It's funny, even in the grief and what he's going through, Bishop said to me, Robert, are the statements ready? And that's the type of person he is. It's all about ensuring that things continue to move. Amen. Amen. We have found out that the God of heaven, He will prosper us. Therefore, we, His servants, will arise and build. Can we stand together? These are not debts that we owe, but these are seeds that we sow into the kingdom of God. And He promises a harvest to those that are faithful to Him. I want to encourage young people, because she also taught me a lot about giving, because I have a tendency to be a little stingy. And why are you laughing at me? And she was on me. She said, nah, son, you have to get it together. You can't be stingy with God. And she put a lot into me. And as many said, she could correct you and you didn't even know you were being corrected. May that spirit rub off on a lot of us old people, where we can correct you. You don't even know we're correcting you. There, Father, we thank you this morning. We thank you for the comfort that we feel in this house. We thank you that you've allowed us in this moment to lift our spirits. And as we've thought about the contribution of our first lady, our matriarch of this house, we ask, oh God, that her spirit would rest upon all of us. And somehow we'll leave this space with a desire to do more, do some of the same in her memory. We thank you for our Bishop, Crystal Lennox. We pray over this offering now as we give. May it be pleasing in your sight. may it bring you glory, may it be acceptable before you. We give you praise and we give you honor, and we glorify you. In Jesus' name we pray. And all the people of God said, amen. The ushers are escorting you to come. And as they do, we also want to leave with you one of her favorite songs she introduced to the church. I will not suffer. I will not beg for bread. To hear from Bishop, and he's going to give you just a short remark. heart before we leave. And I want to thank all of you for doing this with us. How many feel and sense that we have been able to just be comforted together? Amen. Put your hands together. Thank you so much. Amen. There's a song I'm going to ask Kim to lead us in. She's just do a fast version of it. But how many know He sustains? When you're going through the roughest storms in your life, you have a God that will sustain you. Can we stand as a sign of solidarity and lift our hands to heaven and thank Him for being the sustaining God? And the next voice that you will hear will be our bishop as he comes to close us this morning.
Sustaining God, we bless your name. Holding on to your word, it's a light in the dark, a hope for my heart. Seasons come, people change, but you were there at the start. You won't leave at this part. When my heart fails in the faith I know, I find strength in you. You sustain in the middle of it all. You remain the same through the rain. Still you reign. You sustain.
How many believe that this morning?
You sustain. You sustain in the middle of it all. You remain the same through the rain. Still you reign, say you sustain.
Come on, y'all, help me sing this next part.
Say letting go.
Letting go of our fears.
We're not sure what's ahead, but I'm gonna trust what you say. Hallelujah. Say Spirit come. Say have your way. This present moment, I surrender my pride. So Lord is my life.
Lord is my life.
Say you sustain.
Say
you sustain.
Say
in the middle, God remains the same. Still you reign. Say you sustain. Come on, sing it one more time.
Trust you. I will.
you sustain in the middle of it all. God remains the same through the rain. Still he reigns. You sustain. Say you sustain. You sustain. It doesn't matter what you're going through this morning. He will sustain you. He will never change. He is the same God today and forevermore. It doesn't matter how hard it gets. God will sustain. Yes, he will. You say in the middle. Say God remains. Say God remains. Say God remains. Say God remains. Hallelujah. Say you sustain. You sustain. Say in the middle. Say you remain.
You remain the same. You reign. Still you reign. You
stay. I will trust you. You are faithful and true. I make good in you, oh God.
I will trust you.
Say it,
Lord. Oh, I will trust you. Trustworthy, let's bless him together. He's dependable, reliable. He's a friend that sticketh closer than any brother. He's a friend indeed, and a friend when you are in. On behalf of the children, Lennox and Crystal, myself, can you just, if you feel comfortable, just hug somebody, just rest your hand on their shoulder and tell them we appreciate you. We appreciate you. Your love, your support, your prayers. Thank you so much for sharing your reflections with us. When I walked into the service in the opening worship, I wasn't sure I could make it through. But hearing your hearts and feeling you walking with us through this does give a little more strength, you know. I actually choose to want to speak today, and Lennox wants to. Crystal, Lennox, will you come? Crystal just wants to stand with us. I don't know what I would do without them. They have been a tower of strength to me. You may be seated. Throughout all that we do. When they were younger, the question would be, who is coming on the Sunday? Aaron and John had several talks with Crystal in particular. Crystal, you just can't bring everybody without telling me. You got to tell me first, let me know. These two always said, Daddy, you got to do this, Daddy, you got to do that. Yeah. We are indebted to them. Lennox, you know, left for California when the burden became difficult. He came back home to help Christian and myself to go through this. So, it's been a journey. And when it got heavier, I was in Jamaica, and Dawn and I pulled Dawn on the side. Dawn Williams said, Dawn, we need more help, and I've been praying. And do you think Karen would do this to help us? She said, Bishop, don't even ask. Karen would love to. Karen left her job and joined us. I want us to stand and give God praise for her. Karen, let me publicly thank you for all that you did for Joanne and for us. When so much was going on and we needed extra time, I would reach out to her, and Lennox would say, Dad, she needs a break too. No. And you just, you know, thank you so much, Karen. Thank you so much. Thank you. If you needed more help, help us to find Raquel. Raquel, if you're listening to the service, we want to thank you too. So many of you. Janetta, Elder Janetta, forgive me for it. And Sister Humber and all the kitchen crew. Sonia, you're watching us. They made sure every Sunday, Claudette, we had food.
Praise the Lord, everybody. I hope that I have a chance to say more later. Just want to say these three names now, and I'll most likely mention them again, but I want to make special mention for the late Elder Winston Jackson, excuse me, my head is all over the place, the late Deaconess Yvonne Gail Fitz, and the late Sister Chriselle Sheldon Andrews. Thank you to everyone. Thank you for your prayers, your support, flowers, and all of the words of encouragement. Some people, they don't like certain words, but you can give me all the words. I will gladly receive them. So thank you. God bless you all.
Robert, Andrea, just come and listen to something. Can you? If you can, it give me time to get my head together. Andrew was the chief in our wedding, and she's been a dear friend and supported everything. Our three girls are here, the two girls are here today. Our son is not here, Ariane, let's stand again. Can recognize them. So Andrea almost didn't make me get married. When you come by the house, I tell you why.
Praise the Lord, Calvary. You should come by the house because it's a funny story. I knew my cousin was special. And this morning, the outpouring of love and support just showed me how special she was to everyone and not just her family. And so I am just so thankful to God for her life. And I am thankful that you all are here to support Lennox and Crystal and Barrington during this time. And I give God thanks for all that he will do.
Good morning, everybody. I really didn't expect to make any mentions this morning, but I want to thank you on behalf of the entire family for the love, the support, all the reflection, everything that you said, I can relate to it. Joanna was a very special person, very gifted individual, brilliant person, and unselfish with it. She shared it with everyone, me included, Shauna, everybody was included in that. So I thank her for the gifts that she has left us, and we will live on to honor her legacy. So thank you for the support. We certainly appreciate it. And please keep the Golson family in your prayers, in your thoughts every day. They deserve the love. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you. So, Sister Gloria Gale, Minister Gloria Gale, you know, is in the service. We have her speak next week. But in the middle of everything, I wanted to go by and tell her, because she is the only remaining living aunt, 89 strong, and in the middle of all of it, every time I was trying to leave the house on Friday to get to her to tell her, I just couldn't leave. And then the text went out, and she got a notification of Joanne's passing by the text. And she called, and I could hear it in her voice. So Wynne and I went by to see her. So gracious and kind, she said, I knew it was coming. Sister Gail, she was a principal and spent her years in education. And she said when Joan was a little girl, she would be helping Joanne, what was she doing? And Joanne dreamt Joanne on early in the week. She came to her, had a drawing, and she showed her the drawing. And in the drawing was a casket. So she knew it was coming. She knew it was going to be this early. So it made me feel reassured that she was ready. I told the kids I felt she was tired, and I'm glad the children opened up for all of you to come and to visit her. And you got to see her. This February will be 8 years since she was officially diagnosed with dementia. And it was the first time we ever had to take her to the doctor. I'm glad you got to see her. That Sunday morning, I was with her waiting to come, prepared, ready to come to church, but spending that couple of hours with her first and come. And then in the room, she coded her her heart rate went down, and everybody went in a panic. And that's when I told you, I lost it. And when they all rushed in the room, before they could do anything, her heart started beating again. And so the nurse spent some time with me and was trying to make sure I was okay. And when she left, I asked God, I said, why did you put me through that? I said, because I want you to know for the 8 years that she's been sick, I've been holding and keeping her. But I want you to know your wife is really sick. And I said in prayer, I'm not ready yet. The children are not ready yet. And the church is not ready yet. I'm glad he gave us that space of grace. She came back, started eating, and we thought we were going back to the regular normal. But last Sunday, it was evident that she stopped eating again. And I thought, what would I say to you? Just one story. What would I tell you about Gemma? Just one thing. And I figured I'll tell you how I knew at age 17 this was the lady that I should marry. 17. All the young people went out to this Chinese restaurant. Probably about 14 of us. And you heard it before? All right, you not heard before, just act like you never heard it before. Because some never heard it before. How many never heard it before? Raise your hand. And we got in the restaurant, everybody was, young ladies just got in and sat down. All the young guys sat down, but Joanne stood up and she would not sit because she knew she was different. And she waited to see who would pull her seat out and seat her. I think the other guys were clueless, but I spotted the treasure. I should say it this way. The diamond brilliance hit my eye. So I reached over, pulled the seat out, and seated her. And from that day on, she caught my attention. Then another friend of mine, because I was just recently in the church, and he says, there is a young lady in the Bible, Christine, that nobody can beat. I said, what do you mean nobody can beat her? He said, no, she's just so good and nobody can beat her. I didn't know anything about Bible quiz. I wasn't interested in Bible quizzing. So I said, all right, I'm going to join the team. I'm going to beat her. When I went, I found out it was the young lady with the class. So I decided I was going to beat her. I became the champion quizzer that year. I did beat her. I dethroned her from a rain. And then Pastor Stuart Roberts' dad was the Bible quiz coordinator, director. And then the custom is the champion becomes the captain. He made her my captain. So I had to submit. The champion had to submit to her as a captain. From that day on, I realized we were destined to work together. You all know her as very nice. But John is no pushover. She's a straight A student. She started teaching right out of what we call junior college. At 17, she started teaching her high school math and Spanish. At 18, she took a group of 20-something young girls to Mexico. And one of the tourists, one of the Mexican drivers, kidnapped her. Literally, true story. And it's driving off with her, and she screamed Jesus and jumped out the cab. Thank God she wasn't hurt. It's been an amazing story. We got married. We got engaged at 21, got married there shortly thereafter. And for the last 42 years, my life has been blessed. We made a covenant that whoever goes first will never marry again. She was just trying one day figure me out. Long we figured. I could never marry again because I could never find another man like you. So I was smart enough to keep my mouth shut. And she kept on laying on. So I finally said, I'll never marry again. And then she said, oh, who you fooling? She started then teaching at Campion College, which was one of the top schools. She taught at Casey for a little while too, but then full career at Campion College. And in the class was the Prime Minister's son. In the middle of all the political violence in Jamaica. And then they asked her to come to the house and to tutor the two children. She was did that for a while, prepared them for college, and kept going. The violence was so bad, he would send a limousine to pick her up. I'll say to her, Joanne, let them drop you down the corner. I'll come and meet you. And then we walk home. We had a good life. I have no regrets. None at all. I'll be honest and transparent with you. Sometimes I do feel a little sense of anger because I never saw over mature years this way. I thought we'd be able to do much more and travel together and do a lot more than we did, And, but I'm glad we were able to keep her at home and care for her and love her. And those who got to meet her, I pray you'll cherish her memories. Thank you, Wayne. Thank you, Elder John. Elder John will share some stories. They, you know, Wayne lived with us, John lived with us, Robert lived with us. When we were married for the first couple of years before we had Lennox, my pastor would send every troubled soul to live with us. And Joanne never, ever said no. amazing woman. I told somebody one time that was saying, oh, you're so wonderful, and they thought I was sick. I said, well, trust me, you couldn't live one day with me. You couldn't. And you heard her talking to the ladies. She knew how to get me to do what I wouldn't do. I'll say real quickly, I might have the vision, but Joanne did the work. I might have these grand ideas, but Joanne made the plans. And I run from this vision to that vision, and she followed right behind doing all the plans and doing the work. God had truly blessed us. If you never knew, I'll tell you, when I met her and we realized this was serious, I don't know what got into me. I said, you know, I want to be a pastor. That's what my calling is, just around before I turned 18. She said, oh, my God, no. Her grandfather was a pastor. Her best friend, Juliet, they had made an agreement together. They'll never marry anybody in ministry because they didn't want to go through what they saw their parents go through. And here I come along. And she was happy to fall in love with me because I was fresh off the street. Never figure out this one is two. And when I told her that, she said, oh, no way. But when she couldn't hold it out any longer, she maybe made a promise to her. Promise was, I'll not start pastoring, doing any ministry until, number one, I finish college. Number two, I buy the house. Number three, I buy a brand new car. Number four, she has some money left over. Number five, everybody knows she can work and dress herself. And so you wonder why I started pastoring at 32. Because I made up my mind, I'll not do it until I met everything that she wanted. And God honored that. Most people start early, and I started at 32. And because of her partnership, because of her work, her love, she finally said yes to the Lord. This is not what she wanted. Thank God for her. I think I've said enough. So in closing, I said, Joanne would be mad with me if I made this service all about her and not conclude it with a word from the Lord. I know I can't preach this morning. I wouldn't even try. But I have to share something from the Word to honor my wife today. Would you stand with me, please? So I'm just going to read the scriptures and then. Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20 and 21. I was speaking with Robert Gale, and this verse resonated in our conversation. I want to share it with you. Now unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. Unto him be glory in the church by Christ Jesus throughout all ages, world without end. Amen. Father, we thank you for your call. Lord, we thank you for your anointing. But let your glory rest upon us and those who will hear us. Let your will be done. Let your kingdom come here and around the world today. Thank you for being a help. We give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated. Now unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. Jermaine's life and my life is a testimony, and we will continue to believe God, that it will reflect that our God is able. He's able to do exceedingly. He's able to do abundantly. He's able to do above that which we ask and that which we think. Paul, in this verse, is saying to us, for God to do exceedingly abundantly above all, we have to ask and we have to think. God will not do anything for us that we don't ask him to do. It is our responsibility to think and to ask. It is his responsibility to do above that which we think and ask. He will blow your mind, glory to God, with what he can do. We have found out, Joan and I in this church, that sometimes the thoughts that we have are really given to us by him. And when we embrace his thoughts and we open our mouths and begin to ask, we step into the will of God and he takes over and blow our minds. He's just looking for an invitation into our lives and into our worlds to blow our minds. I'm glad for the thoughts of God. One of my mentors that mentored me in my early years to develop prophetic gifting, these were the words that he said to me: trust your thoughts. This day that we're celebrating Joanne's life and reflecting on her, I want to say to you, slow down. Stop being so busy. And start thinking and asking and watch what God will do. He will do exceedingly, abundantly, above that which you ask or think. Why? Because he's able. He's capable. He can do it, but he can't do what you don't think and what you don't ask for. Let your spirits remain pure and clean, undefiled. Never despise the altar, so nothing can separate you from God. So he can download his thoughts into you. Keep coming to church so your faith can be stimulated. And when the thoughts of God hits your mind, you're in an atmosphere that encourages you to open your mouth and ask God, is there anything too hard for a God? No. Hallelujah. I trust her life. All of our lives will continue to allow God to do it. Why? Paul closed, he says, unto him then be glory in the church. God gets glory when his deeds are manifested through us. And all of us are conscious that Nothing that he did or done, we could ever take the credit. Joanne wants you to know it's about him. It's him. It's him. To him be the glory in the church, now and forever, world without end. Amen. Can we stand together and give God glory? Can we celebrate God? Can you open your minds to let him download his thoughts in you? Can you be bold enough to ask of your God, who is able to do above what you think and above what you ask? To our young ladies in particular, don't sell your life short. Your God's eyes are on you, and he will not withhold any good thing from you. Hallelujah. 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 Let's pray. Father, we bless you today. We are indebted to you. Our hearts are heavy, but deep down in our souls, we've got praise and adoration for you. You're a wonderful Savior. You are indeed a burden bearer. Let Joanne's spirit rest upon this congregation. Transfer all of her gifts into these your people. Let the anointing, let the glory, let the grace, let the poise, let the purity, let the love, let the care, let the compassion, let the giving ability rest on them. Father, hear me today. Hold my children into your hand. Keep their mother's memory alive. Comfort them. Glory to God. I'll take my seat and say this to you. So if you ever wondered why the transition and turn the church over into Robert's and Jenny's hand was important, after what you heard today, I hope you understand. I could not effectively pastor this church without having her by my side. I'd be robbing you of what she brought to the table. It takes a set person. It could be the female, it could be the male, but it takes the other person, because the church needs a mother. It needs the female touch. Just like in your homes, it's family's best with mother and dad. I know there are successful homes of single parents, but it's not the same. I'm delighted and I'm happy. I'm comforted to know that you have a pastor and his wife to effectively carry on the work that was started. Clap your hands and receive. Janice, would you come stand by him? Come on, clap your hands and receive them. Come on, you can do better.
Can you give our bishop a hand?
Glory to God.
We want to thank you, Jesus. We want to thank you. Thank you so much for all that you said, all you've done to make this moment bearable. But I'll say this and we'll get you out of here. I know we've gone way over our time, but I thank you for staying. Usually what happens in these things is you get through the whole process and then everybody goes back to their lives and then the family has to shoulder that burden. But I want us to change things a little bit in that culture. Can we agree that we're going to stick together in this process? Can I get a amen? And people have asked what you can do. We'll let you know more that you can do. But you can start by just being consistent and coming out every time we come out so we can heal together. We can bear the burden together, because it's hard when we're just trying to carry it, Lord, by ourselves. So I want to thank you again on behalf of Janice and Judah and all of you, that all the leadership. You've been so gracious and kind. And we're going to do this together. I thought before we close out and let you go, we should sing the song we sing for every ride in the fellowship, but I think it's appropriate in this moment. LJC, can we just raise our voice together? In fact, you might just hold somebody's hand as we do it.
Been through so much change.
We stand together.
We stand together through the sunshine and the rain.
If wrong or right,
if wrong or right,
still we love each other so. When in trouble,
when in trouble, on our knees we go.
Just a reminder, on Tuesday night, we're going to gather here as a family to pray together, to console each other. So please change your plans, move around your schedules. We're going to start by leading with prayer. Amen? Amen? Amen. Thank you so much for your love, your compassion, your concern. Amen.
We thank you, loving Father, that you are our Father, and you're a good, good Father. We thank you for your love that we feel in this place. We thank you for your strength that you have given us through these beautiful memories of Lady G. We pray, God, of the days ahead and the months ahead, that you will continue to undergird us, oh God, with your love, your grace, your strength, and fond memories, oh God. Help us to be there with each other. Be there to support and love and be there. Strengthen us and keep us. And as we're about to depart, oh God, I pray that you will go with us. Cover us on your blood and keep us, Lord God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Before you go, just a reminder, so if you'd like to visit by Bishop's House, we're going to have that visitation start at 3 p.m. just to give them some time to transition. So again, please see Dr. Celia or call her so she can schedule it. Also, can I see the leaders for a brief minute? We're not having our leaders meeting because obviously what's happened, but we just need to see you for a brief minute. Amen. You're dismissed in Jesus' name. Please hug on somebody, greet somebody, and the statements are ready with the ushers as you leave.
Quick thing. For all leaders, we're meeting right here, right at the front, where Pastor usually sits. All right? All leaders in the next 5 minutes. Thank you.